Every child's life is full of surprise, excitement, and discovery. But life has a way of presenting challenges. For children with cystic fibrosis, life can be overwhelming. Today, children with cystic fibrosis have more options than ever to help them lead a full, healthy life. And Children's Healthcare of Atlanta is here to help. Cystic fibrosis is a genetic disease, meaning it is passed from parent to child. It causes thick, sticky mucus to build up in the lungs, digestive system, and other parts of the body. Cystic fibrosis is a unique condition, and children require special treatment for their needs. Team members they will need to see include doctors, nurse practitioners, respiratory therapists, physical therapists, pharmacists, nurses, social workers, child life specialists, and nutritionists. At Children's, we use an interdisciplinary approach to treat patients. Our continuum of care starts with our dedicated team who work together to help your child get better.
I love the fact that we have a multidisciplinary team approach here at Children's with the CF programs. I think it's a huge benefit to our families because it allows them to see everybody in one place across all disciplines and not have to make 50 different appointments all over the city. Sometimes families are surprised that we have members of our team who are not medical professionals, but there are some of us who work under family support services, such as child life and social work. And I think that's an important piece to add into our team approach because all the medical providers who go into the room to talk with a patient or with families talk about their nutrition and their BMI and their lung function and their lab work and their test results and all of the things that are related to the medical aspect. When I go into a room, I want to talk about how is that fitting into your life?
Cystic fibrosis is a complicated condition and requires input and expertise from a whole number of different professionals. We really do follow everybody through from infancy into adulthood. We live their milestones with them. We get to know them and their families really well.
I think all caregivers in cystic fibrosis, if they're in this for more than just a year or two, get so connected to our patients. We always like to say, we look forward to dancing at your wedding, and sometimes that happens. So it's more than just doctor-patient, nurse-patient, nurse-practitioner-patient. It's very much a very close connection. Families and the way they deal with this diagnosis and this illness are critical. We understand that as often as we see the patients in the clinic, we see that child a fraction of his life. And of course, the large majority of his life, he's seen by his family and treated by his family. We can get to the best therapy for individual children that we can, and yet then it's up to the family. And the most successful families with this illness are the ones that all pitch in. And of course, we see that so often. And they're really more than part of the team. They're the central part of the team.
Gavin had been having trouble, abdominal pain and stuff like that for 2 years. So he'd been going from doctor to doctor to doctor, trying to figure out what was going on. I was then pregnant with Jake when we ultimately found out that it was cystic fibrosis. We then decided to have an amnio to see if Jake would have it as well, since it's genetic. So, of course, he turned out to have it also. Children's for us has been amazing because I'll tell you, I had many, many bad relationships with doctors in the whole trying to find out what he had, what Gavin had, the whole experience. So I felt like I'd been burned over and over and over again, and I had grown very defensive with doctors. I had doctors telling me I was a hypochondriac, I was just overprotective, I was first-time mom, and I didn't know what I was talking about. So at Children's, you know, we automatically, with our pulmonologist we got hooked up with, amazing. Our nurse practitioner, amazing. Like the whole CF clinic, we could not be happier with the way things have gone. And I can only say from our experience, you know, they're very respectful. They have a really strong team. mentality. It's been really amazing to actually be heard.
They don't treat you like the boxed subject. In the beginning they do. They say, okay, here's what normally happens, and then they check it out. And every quarter when you come in and you go to clinic at Children's, they look at you as an individual, and they look at how's your breathing treatments going, how's your lung function going, how's your weight, how's your height. Everything is individualized.
We need to have Children's in our back pocket all the time. We can't, oh my gosh, if we had to do it by ourselves, or if we even had to do it with just like a pediatrician, I can't imagine not being an email or a phone call away where I could just say, hey, this is what's going on. What do we do now?
You know, the way that we look at it is we have to be the captain of the ship. We've got to make sure that we are advocates for the kids and that we're doing everything that we can to keep them healthy. But there's no way that we can do it alone. You have to have a supporting cast and a team behind you to make that happen, and that's kind of how you feel. You feel like you've got to lead the charge. You've got to take responsibility because you've got a kid who's really sick, but you have people standing right behind you. Everybody is there when you need them, and they're there before you need them.
We were vacationing with some friends actually on Kiowa Island, and on the way there, John started to complain of what we thought was just a cold, a tummy ache. And we got to the house that we had rented, and the following day he seemed to perk up. Later that afternoon, got sick again, and we took him to the doctor the following morning. The doctor gave him a prescription for some antibiotic, I believe, said he had a common cold, and Tammy, being a nurse, thank God, said his stomach feels a little distended to me. Would you please look at that?
He had emergency surgery for what was a bowel obstruction. And after he had recovered, about a week spent in Charleston, the doctors slowly started asking us questions like, is there a family history of CF? And even as a nurse, you know, when I think CF, respiratory comes to my mind. And so I'm like, golly, no. And why would you be asking me this? He had bowel surgery. And I said, well, we're not saying it's for sure, but when you get home, he needs to be tested. Our experience at Children's has, just from the very beginning, has been great in every aspect, simply because they care for John, and it seems sometimes they care for him as much as we do. They truly, truly have his best interest at heart. And he was diagnosed at 2.5, and so we have been regular visitors to Children's every 3 months, and sometimes more frequently than that when he has had other problems. But every time we're there, he is he's seen by every member of the CF healthcare team. And CF is a disease that affects the whole body, your whole family, and they just take care of every aspect. They take care of our physical needs, they take care of psychosocial needs, his emotional needs. As he's getting older, they address everything.
Cystic fibrosis requires aggressive airway clearance therapy and medicine, along with frequent monitoring by our team. At a clinic appointment, your child may have one of the following treatments that you will continue at home: vest treatment used to shake the mucus loose, clapping patients on the back, inhaled medicines, antibiotics used to fight frequent infections, implanted devices which are surgically inserted to give medicine. Children's will help you to develop the right therapy plan for your child. We typically monitor your child at checkups at least 4 times a year.
One of the first things that we do is educate, and then when they come to see the team at the second visit, one of the first things that we do is emphasize airway clearance, which is chest physiotherapy. Every family's different, and some families are on that bandwagon from day one and never fall off. some families begin to let their guard down. And I also teach that on day one, too. And I say, you know, little Johnny, when he's a teenager, he may not want to do that vest one day. And I try to really emphasize to my families to not let your guard down. Because when that cure is going to come across one day and be available to them, they're going to want their child to be as healthy as possible. Because the people that are going to benefit are those that have healthy lung function and that are more nutritionally sound.
I really believe that people will comply or will adhere if they understand why they're doing what they're doing. And so I try and simplify it without making it scary, you know, trying to find a way to let the patients know exactly why airway clearance is so vital to the pulmonary health, and then what options they have available to them. You can't actually just say, well, this is the kind of airway clearance that you need, because that doesn't always work. You have to fit it with the patient and find out what they enjoy, what they're going to do, what they feel brings benefits to them.
It's gratifying to know that if we do our work in preparing families and inculcating good health habits in the early years, preschool and throughout the school age years, then often they do translate into maintenance of good health habits into those difficult teen years. And then once we get them through the teen years, they go on to their young adult life. And one of the real gratifying things now in cystic fibrosis care is that almost everybody gets into their adult years. One of our paramount goals now is to get them to adult care as healthy as possible, with lung function that is still normal, ideally. Normal lung function entering adult years in the past really used to be a fantasy, and now it's really a reality.
Children with cystic fibrosis need extra calories to grow and develop. Our specially trained team includes gastroenterologists and nutritionists who help guide your child's nutritional needs.
Good nutrition and good pulmonary function go hand in hand. If your lungs are not working well, it'll impact your nutrition. If your nutrition is not working well, it'll impact your lungs.
The goal for children with CF is to achieve as normal growth as any other children. As children get to an age of 5 or 6, and they are now in kindergarten playing with other kids, and they have a lot more interest in playing with the other children than eating their meals. In a child with CF, each meal is important because we're really trying to get them to take the amount of calories that they need.
There are a number of things that we do in our treatment of patients with cystic fibrosis that run absolutely to the opposite of what are the recommendations for most children and most families, and nutrition is a great example of that. While most of America is having problems with increasing issues around obesity, what we've learned in cystic fibrosis is that there is a direct relationship between weight and lung function, and that the heavier the children are, the healthier they are. And so while it is possible for us to make our children obese, it's very unusual that that's actually what's happening. That's a really important piece of our success, though, because you don't have to go back in time very far when we had children who were all underweight and nobody really thought too much about it. The thinking was, well, you know, they're never going to really grow that well. After all, they have cystic fibrosis. What can you expect? And one of the things that we've learned in improving the care of patients with cystic fibrosis, one of the things that we've learned as the key to success in ensuring the health of our patients is to have high expectations.
At every CF visit, we do get to meet with the nutritionist, and she asks about any problems, any needs, talks about what John would eat in a typical day, does his calorie intake versus what he then looks at his exercise regimen and says, okay, John, you need to take it up to, believe it or not, you know, 4,000 or 5,000 calories a day, which sometimes seems impossible, but you learn, and they teach us different tricks to get calories, sneak calories in wherever you can. And,
He's a fan of my high-calorie milkshakes, which I make with ice cream and half and heavy cream. And typically he'll have those right before he goes to bed, so he absolutely has no opportunity then to burn those calories off. These are the things that the nutritionist teaches us. So.
They give you ideas that you never even would have thought of, just to be able to say, okay, I need some help here, and to let you know that there's supplements you can get that are pharmaceutical, there's supplements that you can get over the counter, there's things like that that are just basically weight gain shakes. And that kind of stuff that I wouldn't look at that because you don't get that from a cookbook. They do a pretty strict nutritional plan. Strict in the sense that we have nutritional shakes that we give them religiously. A CF patient has to take in a lot of extra calories. More than, like, for example, our kids in their activity level, they're supposed to take in more than 4,000 calories a day.
You mark, get set, go.
So try getting that into a 6-year-old and a 9-year-old.
It's the first challenge.
Yeah. That's the strict part isn't strict because you're like, here, eat. And all the worst food that we would all love to eat, that's what they get.
It's also a silver lining around the cloud. You know, mm-hmm. They get to basically eat as much, in fact, encouraged to eat as much of junk food as they possibly can.
Yeah, I was so excited when I found that out because I was like, in retrospect, I was like, oh, all those chicken nuggets and french fries, I'm awesome after all.
It's very important that any child with CF have the best nutrition and the optimum weight that they can possibly be, because just a little setback, if he were to have a really bad cold, require a hospitalization, and he was not getting his optimum nutrition, losing 5 or 10 pounds would be devastating. It would be very, very hard for him to regain. Because of the basic defect in CF, it's very hard for him to gain weight, because when he eats, his body doesn't produce the enzymes that you and I do to help us gather all the vitamins and the nutrients and the calories from the food.
Along with treatment and nutrition, physical activity is very important for children with cystic fibrosis. Getting exercise can improve breathing and overall health. The Children's Cystic Fibrosis Program can help you develop the right exercise plan for your child.
So we've encouraged John John to stay active in sports. John John fell in love with soccer, and we believe that's one of the reasons that we've had the successes we have had with his lung functions. He's also an avid swimmer. In addition to that, John John's played a variety of sports. He's played football, he's played basketball. Just an active child. He runs, participated in the ING Marathon on the 65 Roses team.
Get them outside, get them running around, and we have been, we've tried to get them involved in as many things as they can that are cardiovascular, running and soccer and lacrosse and football and
basketball,
any kind of sports that makes them run a lot or use their cardiovascular a lot. Now, sometimes that doesn't work. Wakeboarding is Gavin's passion, and he loves it. He's very good at it, and he just practices, and he does things that most 9-year-old kids just can't even think about doing. That's not so as much cardiovascular.
But his training for it is on the trampoline. So he trains and practices all his flips and everything on the trampoline, so he gets a good
That's a really good workout.
Trampolines are great.
So that's been a big part of their therapy is go play.